With WFA 3.1, we have introduced a couple of new features in the designer aiming to ease the designing of a workflow. We will walk through these new features while trying to create a workflow. Let us log into the WFA portal as an architect. Now, let's create a new workflow to create a cluster data on tap volume and export it over SIFS. This workflow includes multiple stages such as creating a volume in the selected storage virtual machine, creating a SIF share on the volume mount path, and adding access control list on the SIF share. The first step is to search for a cluster on which we can create a volume. With the WFA 3.1 designer, two additional icons have been introduced at the top left corner of the step header. First icon indicates the type of the step, and the second icon indicates the type of certification. Currently, it shows that this command is NetApp certified. Double click on the selected command to add it as a new step in the workflow. Next, we'll create export policy. Add the command as next step by drag and drop. Once we have the export policy ready, we now need to create a volume. Let us search for the create volume command from the list of available commands. We now see multiple results. Please note that this icon confirms it is a command and this confirms it is a workflow. From the search results, we can see that in WFA 3.1, the commands and workflows are now categorized into C mode and 7 mode. In our case, we are trying to create a C mode volume, so we need to add create volume command displayed under the C mode category. Double click on the selected step to add it as the last column in the designer. Let's add the next step to create export rule for SIFS. We realize that export role for SIFS needs to be done before create volume. So now we need to reorder the steps. Reordering is simple in WFA 3.1 designer. We can do it by holding desired step and dragging it to the intended location, as it is shown in the video. We can modify the step alias name by double clicking on the step header as shown here. If needed, we can remove a step from the workflow by clicking here. As the number of columns increase in the workflow, we can increase the real estate for the designer space by collapsing the available steps panel from here. Now, we have added all the required steps as columns to the workflow. In WFA 3.1, all the options in setup details are made as tabs in main designer itself for easy navigation and modification. Now we have added multiple rows in the workflow. With WFA 3.1, the designer provides various menu options for rows, such as insert new row above or below current row selected. We can copy a row and paste it above or below the currently selected row as well. Now it is possible to apply a condition for the entire row. This is displayed as a diamond shaped icon. Enabling or disabling the approval point is now possible with a click. We can view the ready for production and last updated on information on the bottom bar of the designer for the respective workflow. So now we have successfully and easily created a workflow with the help of new designer. Happy trying WFA 3.1. Thank you for watching.